Well, top of the morning to ya. This is my morning routine video. I hope you guys enjoy it. It took forever to edit and film, so I really hope you like it. The first thing I do is usually I wake up by Daisy. She usually whines or something. And I check all my social media sites, and then I let Daisy up into the bed, and I just lay with her and cuddle with her, and we high five and stuff because she's a really great high fiver. If you don't know, I have an Instagram video of her doing it. She's so funny. So she's my first priority in the morning. I just like to play with her and spend quality time with her as much as I can. And we also had like a little mini photo shoot after I filmed that first part. So here's some of her pictures. I'm a proud mama. Look at that cute little face. Okay, so also after I, you know, play with her a little bit, I take her out for her potty run. Yes, I do go out looking like this at the apartments because I have nobody to impress at about 8 o'clock in the morning. So I come back in and I focus on myself and I start brushing my teeth. That's the main priority, right? And then after I'm done brushing my teeth, I'm going to go ahead and take a shower. Shampoo I'm using is the Biolage Hydrating Shampoo, and then I go in with my conditioner for the weekend. It's the Macadamia Deep Repair Mask. Face wash I'm using is Purity from Philosophy, and then the body wash I love is the Tone Body Wash. And then I use these two moisturizers, the Take a Deep Breath from Philosophy. I use that for my face, and then I use the Bobbi Brown Hydrating Under Eye Cream for my eyes. I use both of these every day and every night. I am so obsessed with them, I can't even tell you enough. Then, after I shower, let my hair kind of air dry for just a little bit, I go in with a wide tooth comb. You can get these anywhere, and I just wide tooth comb my hair. Then I'm taking the Kenra Platinum Blow Dry Spray. I actually ran out of this in this video. I was so upset. I have to get another one. But I love this stuff. And then I take the Big Sexy Hair Blow Dry Volumizing Gel. I put this all throughout my hair from roots to ends. I love this stuff. I've been loving Big Sexy Hair products lately just because I want really voluminous hair. Speaking of Big Sexy Hair, I'm going to take the Root Pump and I'm going to put this all into my roots. This is going to give that extra volume. I love this stuff. You can use it so many different ways, but I like to put it in my hair when it's damp and then blow dry it. But before I blow dry it, I'm going to use my Argan Oil from Noumi. Love this stuff. I still use it. I've been using it for a few months now, like a long time actually. I think since November. And I'm just going to put this in my ends, and I'll have everything I've talked about in this video down below, along with coupon codes for a lot of products as well. So I'm using the Noumi blow dryer, and I honestly have no pattern to how I blow dry my hair. I blow dry it upside down, to the side, to the other side, and I kind of just toss it all over until it's completely dry. I don't use a brush when I'm blow drying my hair. I just kind of toss it all around, and then I brush it out once it's all completely dried. And that helps with like a lot of breakage and stuff. So now I'm going to put my hair up, and then I'm going to start off with this Urban Decay B6 spray. I'm trying to give this stuff a chance, so I'm trying to use it as much as I can. And then I'm going in with my Benefit Porefessional to help me out with some of the pores I have on my face. I love this stuff. I mentioned it in my last haul that I will link at the end of this video. For foundation, I didn't have a picture of it because this is a sample, but it's the NC35 MAC Pro Longwear Foundation. I like this a lot. I'm going to blend it in with my beauty blender, and yeah, just blending it. I love the beauty blenders. I have no bad things to say about them other than they're a pain to clean because it takes forever, I feel like. Going in with my MAC Pro Longwear concealers as well, I'm going to put these underneath my eyes. I use NC 20 and 30. I just mix them together, and then again, blend it out with my beauty blender to make it seamless, and then set them in place with this Makeup Forever Transparent Powder. Setting my makeup with my Benefit Hello Flawless Powder. This is like in toasted beige, I do believe. This also helps my foundation match my neck and body a little bit more. Then I'm going in with my MAC, what is it? Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. And then bronzing my face with my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Give Me Sun. I've been using this so much lately. I'm very proud of myself. I've kind of become obsessed with it. It's just amazing. Then taking my new MAC blush, it's called Melba. I'm just going to apply this with my blush brush. And then starting off with the eyes, I'm going to take Stila's Individual Shadow in Kitten. This is so beautiful. If you've never tried it out, you need to. I was skeptical too, but honestly, it is so dang beautiful. And then I'm going to take the Naked Basics palette. I'm going to use Naked 2 all over the crease and just blending it out with a fluffy blending brush. And then I'm going to take Naked 2 and Faint Mix together. applying that on my lower lash line with a pencil brush, and this just adds a little bit more depth. For my brows, I'm going to use the same brow routine that I have. I have a video on it. I'll link it down below. Just using my brow bar to go, and if you want to see a full in-depth video, I will link it, like I said, in the bottom bar. Now I'm taking my all-time favorite liner. This is Jordana's Fabuliner. It is hands down the best one I've ever tried before. And then I'm taking WOS from the Naked Basics palette, and I'm just using this as a highlight as well. And then going in with my amazing, adored mascara is the YSL Baby Doll. Ugh, I can't get enough of this stuff, you guys. I can't say it enough either. And then I'm going to line my eyes. My lower waterline is with the nude liner from Rimmel. And then the upper waterline was the CoverGirl Ink It liner in black. Now I'm lining my lips with Stila's lip liner in Aspiring. This helps my lips look a lot fuller, so I love that. Then I'm taking my MAC lipstick in Hue, which has been a favorite of mine this month. And if you've seen it in videos and asked me what it was, it has definitely been this one for the month. Then I'm taking MAC Pro Longwear Lip Gloss in Patience Please. I obviously love the Pro Longwear line, so definitely try it out. So now I brushed out my hair, and I'm going to be putting in a couple extensions. I used 3 wefts, and these are from Bella Me. If you've been watching me for a few months now, you know that I love Bella Me. I've mentioned them a lot in my videos, in my favorites videos, and also if you look in the bottom bar, I mention them a lot in, you know, my hair section, because I always tell you what I curl my hair with or straighten my hair with. I usually have my Bella Me extensions down there as well. I know I have really long hair, but I wear extensions to add thickness, and these are perfect. I mean, they're honestly the only extensions that I think are worth the money, and I've had a few companies send me extensions, and I won't even, you know, feature them on my channel because I just think they're kind of horrid. Like, they're really scraggly and thin, and they just don't look natural, and they honestly don't do anything for your hair. But I love these because they give me the desired fullness that I want, and it's not a lot of effort either. I mean, 3 wefts is not a lot to put in your hair to get the desired, you know, thickness that you want. I did dye mine to match my hair color. They were a lighter brown, but the darker brown that Bella Me has does match my hair a lot better. But currently, I need to use these because my hair is fading, and they match these extensions a lot better. When my hair is like freshly dyed, then they'll match the darker brunette shade that Bella Me has. So yeah, and then on this side, I'm about to show you guys. I use the clip weft over here because I don't have that much hair on this side, so I like to add a lot of fullness over here to kind of balance out everything. And if you guys are interested, I still do have my $5 off coupon for Bella Me. That's always going to be in the bottom bar for you guys if you're interested. And I mentioned in my last video, but if you are going to BeautyCon, I will be at the Bella Me booth. I would love to meet you. Honestly, I've never been to LA. I've never met anybody. So I would love to meet you. Please stop by the booth. They'll also have really great coupons and stuff, and you can definitely look at the extensions and see if you like them. You know, you kind of get a hands-on experience. So this is what the 3 extensions look like in my hair. As you can see, there's a lot of hair going on, right? And I'm going to take my Numi 25mm wand. I also have a coupon code for this down below. I have a coupon code for a lot of things in this video. So yeah, I'm just curling my hair with this. You guys have seen me do this a ton of times. So if you want to see an in-depth video, I will link it below. But I'm just wrapping all the hair around the wand, and all the curls are going away from my face. It's really easy, nothing too crazy. So yep, that's all I do. It doesn't take that much time at all, honestly. And then I wanted to show you guys Daisy because I looked over and she had her head around the door and was like watching me. It was so cute. I just love that dog. And this is what my hair looks like after I've curled it. I didn't brush through them or anything. I'm just leaving them like this. And then I'm taking this straight sexy hair smooth and seal. I know it says straight sexy, but you can use this for curly hair as well too. So I just spray this all throughout my hair just to kind of give it some more shine as well and make sure it doesn't get frizzy or anything like that. And then this is what the hair looks like and the makeup. We're finally done with it, and I love it. It's definitely my go-to weekend look. It's really easy, and it kind of looks effortless, right? I don't know. So let's go on to my closet. So now we're in the closet, and in Georgia, it's kind of been chilly and rainy, so I went with something that was kind of more fall-inspired, but nothing like long sleeves or anything like that. So this is the outfit I chose. It is a top from H&M, And I like this top, but it's definitely not figure flattering. So I tucked in the side a little bit to kind of show off my waist, to show that I actually had one. And then I paired it with these American Eagle jeggings. They're black. My purse is by some girl, I forget. I'll put her name below. And then my sandals are from Forever 21. And that's just my really easy casual look. I'm a very casual kind of person, and that's how I like it. So that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed seeing Daisy again. She's getting so big. And yeah, if you want to see a nighttime routine, please like this video, and I will see you all in my next one. Bye. You took my heart.